I'm assuming you clicked on the link for this video because you want to figure out how to find the best martial arts gym for yourself. I'm going to give you three things to think about while you're looking for the ideal gym for you to start training. Okay, my name is Dan Slobodin. I've been training for about 20 years in kickboxing and Muay Thai, and about 10 years off and on in jiu-jitsu. I've trained at dozens of gyms, well maybe not dozens, but about a dozen gyms in Thailand, in Holland, in the States, in Canada, and I've taught at about a dozen gyms as well. So I'm gonna give you a couple of thoughts that you might wanna consider as you're looking for a gym. The first one is location, the second one is facilities, the third one is culture. And I think the third one's the most important one, and I'm gonna get into that in detail near the end of the video. So location is pretty key. You want it somewhere close. 10 to 15 minutes drive, or biking, or work transit, whatever you're doing, is ideal for most people, unless there's a specific thing you wanna do. If the gym's too far away, you're probably not gonna go as often. When you're thinking of location, actually think about the location of the gym itself, the neighborhood it's in. If it's in a sketchy neighborhood and you're going there late at night and you gotta walk to get to your car to get to transit, you might wanna reconsider. If you are driving, make sure they have parking. If you are taking your bike, is there a place for your bike to be locked up? If you're taking transit, are they near transit? Are they near a bus or SkyTrain station? These are important things that are gonna help make sure that you keep going to the gym. You might get excited and go a few times, but it becomes harder and harder to go. You're gonna go less and less. So try and find a gym that you're gonna be able to get to easily and comfortably. Number two is the facilities. I have trained at multiple gyms around the world, like I was saying. I have trained at little hole-in-the-wall gyms where there's nothing there, and I've learned a ton. I've also trained at big gyms with world champions, with very famous instructors. They have every heavy bag imaginable, rings, cages, all that stuff. And those are great gyms too. It all depends on what you're looking for and what you have near you. You might be in a city that doesn't have a lot of options, so you might have to like kind of pick and choose and just hope for the best. But it also depends on what you're willing to pay for. If you're paying 50 bucks a month, don't expect a world-class gym necessarily. You might still get really good instruction though, so don't let that disqualify it. You know, the lack of facilities. And again, if you're in a big gym, you have all these things, be prepared to pay a bit more. Those things cost a lot of money. Big gyms, real estate, all that stuff, it needs to be cleaned. It costs money. It costs money to run a gym, and be willing to pay for that money if you want big fancy things. The other things to think about for the facilities are some of the things like the amenities. Do they have showers? If you're training at 6 o'clock in the morning, you're gonna go to work after, you're gonna wanna have a shower. If they don't have showers, that might make it harder for you to go to work. That means you have to go home, or it just might not work out for you. Do they have like a smoothie bar? Do you wanna eat after? For me, that's not important, but that might be important for you. I know a few gyms that it's like a must. So make sure they have the things that you're gonna need or the things that you really want, because it's gonna make the experience more enjoyable for you, and you are going to go more often. Okay, the third one, and probably the most important one, I think, is the culture of the gym. There's gonna be different types of gyms. There are some gyms, like I teach at Gracie Baja Vancouver, it's known as, you know, their tagline is jiu-jitsu for everyone. So there's classes there for just about everybody. We have all sorts of people coming in from all walks of life, from all sorts of different physical abilities. We do have a competition team. We have the kickboxing and boxing. We compete, you know, semi-regularly, but it's a gym from almost anyone. It's very family orientated. It's very kid-friendly, stuff like that, right? So if you wanna be in a gym and you wanna be able to drop F-bombs all the time, that might not be the gym for you. Some gyms have, you have to wear their shirts, their gis, their gloves. You have to have all that stuff. Some gyms, you show up with whatever you want. As long as your gear's clean and relatively safe to use, then that's all you need. You're gonna find a gym that you're gonna find that culture, and there's gonna be more things with it like that as well. So one of those things might appeal to you more than the other one. Try and find a gym that has that stuff. Chances are, if they have things like that that you like, the rest of the culture is gonna make sense for you as well. If you're going to a gym that's fitness-based, don't expect to learn a bunch of self-defense techniques. Don't expect to get a bunch of proper technique. You're gonna go in, you're gonna get a workout, you might meet some people, you're gonna have some fun. If that's what you're looking for, that's great. If you're looking to fight, that gym's not gonna work for you. And vice versa, if you're going to a fighter's gym, you just wanna get a workout, the coaches there are gonna be more invested in their fighters. They might not have time to teach you all that stuff. They're gonna be like, yeah, you go do this, you go hit the bag, go do that for a little bit. You're still gonna get a workout, but you're not gonna get attention to detail that you might want. So try and find a gym that's gonna align to your goals. You wanna get fit, find a fitness gym. You wanna learn how to fight and get fit, find a gym that has a little bit of both. You wanna just really focus on good fighting, find a gym that has a good fight team and a track record and a coach that has the experience. Speaking of coaches, a lot of people make the mistake that if a coach isn't a world champion, they can't make world champions. And that's not always true. Sometimes the best fighters aren't necessarily the best coaches and vice versa. And sometimes they are. Sometimes a world champion can be a world champion class coach. Duke Rufus, for instance, I trained under him for a little while. He's a world champion. He's created world champions. I trained with Kieran Fitzgibbons recently. He's not a world champion, but he's trained many world champions. Greg Jackson, he is 0-1. That's one loss in professional MMA, and he's created a ton of champions. He's probably one of the most successful MMA coaches in the business. So don't worry about what the coach has done. Worry about what they're doing for their students, for their competitors. So to sum it up, find a location that works for you, that you can get to. Find the facilities that you want and that you're paying, that you're willing to pay for. And find the culture, find the type of gym that's gonna work for you for the long term. You don't wanna go to a gym because there's a bunch of flashy fighters there. You go there and then you decide you don't wanna fight and you just feel like you're being fed to the fighters. They're just beating you up and you're not learning anything. Make sure you're finding the right gym that's gonna work for you. That way you'll be invested in it long term, you're gonna enjoy it more, you're gonna go more often, you're gonna get more out of it. So that's my advice for you guys. I hope you enjoy it. I'm gonna be doing some more videos on what to expect when you first start training, what you can do to make your training better when you first start, to get more the most out of it. So make sure you hit subscribe so you get those videos when they come up. And thanks for watching. I'll see you guys soon.